Who operated a successful YouTube channel? Me. Bree. Fuck this. And fuck you for even bringing that shit up. I did nothing wrong. I did nothing wrong. Oh, the camera's on. The camera's been on the whole time, huh? I don't even know. Hello. DarkSydePhil. What better low-hanging fruit to start this series off with than this dumpster fire of a person? Now, I'm not here to retell the tale of DSP. It's been told a million times already and is a fucking cliche at this point. But I'd rather show you guys his character and what kind of person he is and why he is one of the most hated people on the internet. I mean, there are people out there who have created channels solely to mocking and making fun of him on a daily basis. And a lot of them are just pure fucking gold. Here's a few of my personal favorites. Everything was right, everything correct. I
did nothing wrong, I did nothing wrong. I mean, no one here knows anything. Okay. This is great. I know you're loving this story. I'm loving the story.
Talk about perfect timing. You know you've entered a DSP video game stream when the first thing that greets you once you get in is the fucking words in giant bold lettering. Mission failed. And the seal goes. But there's one sound
that no one knows. What does the fake say? Fuck it! It's this controller, dude. It's bugged. I was hitting roll. Fuck this game!
Them motherfuckers are absolute geniuses. I'm gonna put a bunch of their channel names on screen just because if it wasn't for them and their entertainment and them following DSP and his bullshit antics, this video wouldn't have been possible. So big ups to every single person you see on this fucking screen right now. But it doesn't just stop there. DSP's a huge wrestling fan, and some genius got front row tickets and trolled him on WWE SmackDown.
And explain to me why. So in yourself.
Absolute fucking legend right there. I cheers you, my brother, because that was fucking gold. But now that we've got the laughs out of the way, let's finally begin the video. This is the Moron Files for DarkSydePhil.
Phil's fat. Phil's a loser. Phil's a loser.
What better way to get a look into what kind of person DSP is than to examine what he does for a job? See, DSP is a Twitch streamer and is a pro gamer.
I myself am a former pro fighting game player.
And despite that title, he is absolute dog shit at video games. Your kids are better than him at video games. There are people out there that can't even wipe their own ass that are better than him at video games. A whole series has spawned on the internet called This Is How You Don't Play, where they go through Phil's gameplay and highlight his failures and how bad he is at games. That's how terrible he is. But we're not talking about it because he sucks at video games. I'd rather show you guys how he rationalizes sucking at video games. So, let's take a look at him playing a series that I like and that I play, and just listen to his excuses and bullshit.
Explain it. Walking straight forward, know where the bullets can go, but straight ahead into his body, they're not hit detecting, and then he just gets a cheap kill on me. He didn't even earn it.
Allow me to explain, DSP. See, you were hip-firing. When you hip-fire, bullets go everywhere. They don't go straight. It's not a laser.
Of course we lost. They cheated like crazy. That won't hurt our reputation. That quickscoping shit is 100% cheating. You cannot do that in a friggin' real first-person shooter. This is all aim assist nonsense. Aim assist, instant kill. Aim assist, instant kill. Aim assist, instant kill. None of this is earned. Not a single one earned. Not a single... Five. Look. Five kills unearned. Five unearned. All aim assist.
Oh yeah, quick scoping's just cheating, aim assist, unearned bullshit, right? Right, DSP? These guys don't have any skill, no, they just quickly aim down and the aim assist locks onto the enemy. It's not like they practiced and, you know, gotten good at that skill. No, all aim assist bullshit. But if it's so easy to do and so overpowered, why don't you do it? It's almost as if you know you're full of shit.
Enemy UAV above.
Fuck this game. I mean it. It's bullshit. Fuck this game. He's dancing between my bullets and gets an instant sniper shot. No, the game sucks.
How did I die, dude? I was just standing there and I died. Fuck this game, man.
They were not visible. They were not visible. Fuck you, Treyarch, again.
I really don't know what's worse here. The fact that the dumbass is saying the guy was invisible when he didn't check the room? Or the fact that when he goes into the building, he turns and is aiming at the doorway where his own barbed wire is. So his bullets would have just destroyed the fucking thing and not killed anyone he was shooting at. Like, bro, how are you this fucking bad? I can't even try to be this bad.
What? Again? How was I insta-killing? Look at this nonsense. Look at this. Why did I get insta-killed?
The knife has always been an insta-kill. Except in like one or two COD games. What are you talking about?
Again, he fired and missed and insta-killed me. Miss? Look at that! Dude, are you kidding me? Why is it in the game? It's broken as fuck. An instant kill with a fucking knife. He misses his fucking sniper throw, immediately switches to a throwing knife and gets an insta-kill? You're gonna tell me that's not broken?
That has been a thing since Modern Warfare 2. All the way back in 2009. You starting to notice the pattern here? Let's play a drinking game. If you guess it wrong, you gotta take a shot. So, as you can see, he can see the guy right there. He's aimed in and can see his red name. Does he A, shoot and kill the guy, B, take a couple bullets and duck for cover, or C, jump out the window and complain about the guy being invisible?
They were completely invisible. Weren't invisible on my screen.
Now, I know there are a few of you out there probably thinking to yourself, so what if he's bad at video games and makes excuses and lies about it? You know, we've all been there. It's not like those traits carry over into the real world and into real issues, right?
I need that money. I need that money. I need that money.
So fucking bad.
I need that money. I need that money. I need that money. Money, money, money.
If I was to go over every single lie and scam DSP has committed over the years, this video would be 5 hours long. There was that time he scammed his fan out of 20 bucks. That time where he told his fans where he needs to go see his parents because he doesn't know how much longer they're going to be left on this earth because they're getting old and sick. And then when he goes out there to see him, gets married. And all the other bullshit reasons he gives for his begathons. You know, there's a lot of bullshit that surrounds him when it comes to money. I wonder why. But I wanted to focus on some of his really fucked up actions, scams, and lies that he's done in the past few years. And we're gonna start with the Project 7 Patreon scam.
The money is always right!
For those of you who don't know what Project 7 was, it was a sketch miniseries that DSP and his buddies John Rambo, Howard, and Respect the Pack created, and lasted 4 episodes before ending. Remember those names because they become important later on in this section. But a few years later, DSP put a Patreon goal up where if he got $1,200, he would reboot or at least attempt to work on a reboot of Project 7.
And now, quite honestly, again, I'm going to be honest with you, I don't know what to do regarding Project 7, so allow me to talk a little bit about it, ladies and gents. My whole intention, right, when I started early this year, I said this year I would really like to take some time to work on Project 7. I'll be honest, if people were saying to me, coming to me and saying, Phil, we're bored, we don't like your content, You know, we don't want to watch. We'd rather you dropped everything and worked on Project 7. I would say, okay. But that's not the feedback I'm getting. What I'm getting is people want to see me play all these things that are coming out. Everyone, and yes, I'm going to be working on Project 7. I'm going to be brainstorming ideas on what it would look like to bring it back, to do maybe a kind of a teaser trailer, and get some ideas of how to restart that series.
Now, you can tell by his reaction that he had absolutely no intention of this goal getting hit. Because he probably put this up thinking it would get him a few extra $100 a month but not reach the goal, and gets shocked when the goal actually gets reached. But DSP is a man of his word. He's definitely going to follow through for his fans and not renege on this, right?
That right now, the consensus is, even though people would like to see Project 7 come back, they'd want to see it as a quality product. They don't want to see a rushed piece of crap. And it also seems to me that right now in particular, that we're at the end of the summer, with the limited time I have left before the new releases start coming out, people would much rather see me focus on Fallout New Vegas, finishing Metroid Prime. I'm not going to rush and try to put out a piece of crap Project 7 for you that I don't think would be up to the quality standards that I want to set, just because I said that I would do it when all these circumstances have kind of happened. And almost, like I said, it's almost like the planets aligned and are telling me, don't do Project 7 now. And so, as of right now, I'm officially announcing I'm not doing it right now. It doesn't make sense, all right?
Oh, wait, that's literally exactly what he did. But you know what? Maybe he's telling the truth. Maybe his fans don't give a shit that they pledged $1,200 to this man to reboot a certain series and receive a product. Maybe they just want to see Phil play the hot new games. It's not like he talks about this in the future and completely changes his story.
Phil stole fan donations that went towards a Project 7 reboot. Fan donations, they weren't fan donations, they were Patreon contributions, that's different.
Yes, they were contributions towards a product to which you never delivered upon.
That went towards a Project 7 reboot. Wrong, it wasn't for a Project 7 reboot. It was for me to take some time out that month to do a Project 7 reboot trailer.
Here's a screenshot of the Patreon goal level. Please tell me where in the fuck it specifies that this is for a trailer. Because I'm pretty sure it says he's rebooting the series. Not that he's taking some time off to make a trailer. You are blatantly fucking lying here.
A trailer that was probably going to be 30 seconds long.
And yet you still didn't make it, you fucking liar.
I just care about money. I need money.
All the way back in 2019, DSP held another begathon, where if he hit the tips goal of $1,000, he would reveal some big positive news to his stream and his community. And if they doubled that tips goal, there would be a further reward and further bigger news. What could it be? Is his wife pregnant? Hell, maybe he doesn't have to file for bankruptcy. Maybe this news is going to turn around his public image and make people not hate DSP. I wonder what this news could be.
You guys ready for a big positive reveal? I hope you are.
Oh, trust me. We can't wait, DSP.
I got someone I'd like you to meet. I would like to introduce you to our pet. Yeah, here we go. Perfect. This is Jasper, ladies and gentlemen. Jasper the cat.
He really just had people donate over $1,000 to him. For him to tell them that he has a cat. How the fuck is this not a scam?
Basically, he's been a part of our lives for a long time. Alright, in fact, before the wedding and everything this year, you know, a lot of people surmised, they were like, Phil, why is it that you needed to have a friend come by the house and kind of house it for you while you were in Connecticut to get married? There's your answer.
Well, it's funny you say that, because literally not even 3 months before this happened, you said this! Flashback.
Super Flash said, would you and Kat get a cat if Chat helped pay? I mean, maybe. Like, now we've decided we're definitely staying here in this house, so that's not really a concern, it would be more of a money thing. But, Kat really wants a cat, so just saying.
End of flashback.
Wanted to kind of reveal him for a long time now, but with all the stuff that's been going on in our lives, personally, we wanted to wait for the right time.
He just needed to wait for the right time. You know, when he had no other ideas of how to make money. He just wanted to wait for the right time to reveal that he has a cat after scamming his fans out of $1,000. If you're a DSP fan and you contributed to this, congratulations.
You played yourself.
That douche kid cheered. He said, the joke's on everyone. I don't see why you think the joke's on everyone. What's the joke? It was a positive reveal. It's something that's going to affect our streams positively. Hey, buddy. Because he's going to be hanging out with us. So I don't know why you think that this is a negative. It's not. It's a great positive.
Dude, you are being intentionally dishonest here. You know why this won't go over well. You know why the joke's on everyone. It has nothing to do with the fact you had a pet. You could have revealed to the world that you had a pet, and it wouldn't have caused a shitstorm at all. The reason why people are up in arms about it is because instead of just revealing this to your stream, you charged your fucking fans $1,000 to tell them that you have a cat. That's why people are pissed. And you said that Jasper's going to be a positive addition to the streams and he's going to join you now on stream. He's barely ever on stream since this. And when he is there, DSP kicks him out because he pisses him off.
Used to be my dog, you was in my left titty. Scream, ride or die, I thought you would die with me. Found out you a bitch, you can't even ride with me. Now it's a war, you ain't on the side with.
Earlier, I told you guys to remember the names John Rambo and Howard from Project 7. Well, that's because they ended up having a falling out with DSP, and it was never public knowledge as to why. DSP would later come out and give different stories as to what happened between him, John, and Howard and the whole Project 7 shit. And although some of the things DSP says in here are truths, John and Howard tell a very different side of that truth. So instead of just nitpicking and explaining every single part as to why DSP's lying, I'm just going to play what DSP says and then play what John and Howard have to say and let you guys decide.
We'll say, to this day, say, well, Phil scammed his friends, or he ripped off his friends and never paid them for anything, and that's why they hate him to this day. Bullshit. I will now tell you guys, he was handsomely paid for all of that stuff. When we first started, he got paid 50% of everything that we made money on. He got half of what I made. So every Saturday, John comes over. If we made a ridiculous amount of money on what we did that day, he got half.
It's not exactly the truth, okay? So, and I had to come to him and ask, because we're still doing videos. I said, since you're getting something for this, do you feel that I should get a percentage of that for my efforts on here, right? Make an agreement, which will be basically half of the month. Half of the month's co-op income. For instance, like, if it's March, and we do videos in March, I will get a percentage of what was made in March. That does not include residuals, like, for months coming up. Like, for instance, if those videos make more money in April or June and July. So just to flat out say he got 50%, it's far from true.
In fact, the pack didn't want any money at all. I had asked them up front, what do you guys want out of this? And they said, we want exposure. There was never discussion that people were going to get paid based on how the videos performed on YouTube. There was never discussion about how much money anyone's investing in the series. There was never discussion about anyone getting a paycheck out of it. Ever.
So I had a conversation, like Howard said, I had a conversation with Phil. I said, listen, you have to make it worth their while, man. Throw them money. And I'm not saying throw them like thousands of dollars. His response, they don't want money.
Yeah. And then I asked him about it, and they said he didn't even talk to them.
Let me ask you, did you get anything out of the Project 7?
First of all, we're going to talk about that. Not, I didn't get shit out of Project 7.
So no one got paid.
What happens, right? We go ahead. We don't get our cut, which is whatever at this point. But we start showing up to your house, and what do we see? The guy starts buying figurines, starts buying all this ridiculous shit that there's no need to buy. Then we show up to his house one day, and what does he have in a fucking driveway? A BMW. So how the fuck do you think I feel, and how do you think these guys feel after the
Recently, DSP's Twitch moderator Discord was leaked by none other than that fan I mentioned earlier, Anonymous. He became disgruntled with DSP and the other moderators and said, fuck it, and full-sended this shit.
He does not care! I don't care! I don't care! He does not care! I don't care!
And leaked it all, even linking a perma-join link to it. This shit exposed so much. I mean, it contained things from him belittling his fans and moderators and holding their status over their head, to him belittling a victim of child sexual abuse, and to him doxing his own fans. Now, the portion I'm going to talk about is him doxing one of his own fans, because he's actually addressed this publicly.
He says, I heard you doxed PW Dubs, is that true? No, I didn't publicly dox anyone. It's complete false bullshit. Some random stuff happened with him that I talked to my moderators about, but I did not disclose any information that he didn't want disclosed.
Here is a list of PW Dubs' information that was not censored that when DSP posted it into the Discord chat server. Full name, date of birth, partial address, height, sex, eye color, issue date, military status, endorsements, license class, and partial signature. And all this information has been verified.
Societies, no, there was no public doxing of PW Dubs or anyone else. When did I post any information anywhere about him? No one. Nothing.
Notice how he says I didn't publicly dox anybody, which technically is a true statement. He just doxed him in his private Discord moderator server. You are such a fucking liar. How is anybody a fan of this guy?
In fact, I've never publicly doxed anyone. I didn't publicly dox anyone. There was no public doxing of anyone. But, you know, talking with my moderators behind the scenes about here's what happened with a guy. He sent me an email and here's what he sent. And he blocked off certain information he didn't want shared. That's not doxing. That's stupidity.
He sent that message to you for your eyes only, DSP. And what do? You take it and post that picture to your Discord moderator server without censoring any of that information. That means you doxed him. I hope so far I have put on display the kind of character that DSP is. That he is willing to lie to try to save face. That he is willing to scam his fans. And he is willing to make up any excuse in the book and blame anybody and everything but himself for his fucked up actions. Because this has all been building and culminating to our final act of this video. The main reason I even decided to make this. His most egregious and fucked up scam and bullshit fucking lies that he's been spinning for the past year regarding this subject. Now, I'm not the kind of person that pocket watches somebody. Go out there, do your hustle, make that fucking money. But when you're such a notorious scammer like DSP, it makes me wonder where that money's actually going. And he actually provides a very reasonable explanation. See, DSP's in financial ruin. He's maxed out 13 credit cards, has 2 mortgages, and had to recently file for bankruptcy. So it's not that much of a logical leap to think that that's where all the scam money is going to. Enter WWE Champions, a mobile game that's pretty much a Candy Crush ripoff with WWE wrestlers in it. This game, like most mobile games, is an absolute cash grab. When you log in, you're greeted with microtransaction after microtransaction after microtransaction. It's just trying to milk you for as much money as you're willing to pour into it. So you're wondering, what has this got to do with DSP? Well, January 10th, 2020, a user on Kiwi Farms posted a thread showing that there's an account on the WWE Champions leaderboards by the name of They Call Me DSP. This is the same unique name that DSP has as his Twitter handle with the same exact capitalization. After further digging into this, they found that this account is a very high level and belongs to a very high leveled faction. In fact, one of the top 5 in the world. And his roster sported one of the best rosters in the game. And WWE Champions, being the cash grab that it is, the only way to obtain that level in that roster is to spend money within that game. Because after hitting a certain point within the game without spending money, you're maxed out and you can't progress any further without spending cash. After doing some more digging and research into the WWE Champions game, they were able to determine that to get that level that this account was at and to sport that roster, that account had to have spent at an estimate of $40,000. Let me reiterate that just in case you thought you misheard me. That account had to have spent $40,000 on this. The Kiwis followed this account very closely and discovered it only logs in when DSP isn't streaming. Now this could be by complete coincidence, so we're going to need more proof. The Kiwis were eventually able to get an inside man into the Uselessness Faction's Discord server, where they uncovered that this DSP account is in there talking, bragging about its most recent pulls from the newest event, but bitching about how much money they had to sink into it. These were screenshotted and leaked on April 13th, 2020. They were met with some form of criticism, some people saying that this was just an elaborate Photoshop. I personally think that if this was a Photoshop, it's the best I've ever seen. But they needed more proof. They then took the Discord leaks and the text in there and then compared it in a linguistic software to the way DSP tweets. This software is accurate up to an 85 percentile, and it matched DSP at 98%. The computer even thought that the people doing this were fucking with it. Still though, it's not like he's ever admitted to playing this game.
Play a game called WWE Champions, which of all things, if you can believe it, is a WWE game that plays like Candy Crush. It's basically just moving gems around and breaking colored gems.
Adding more weight behind the Discord leaks was they took the unique ID number from that DSP account and compared it to the ID number from DSP's Discord moderator server that was leaked in January of 2020. They compared it and it was a match. No two accounts can have the same unique ID number. Speaking on that, I completely forgot to mention that this dude claimed up at this point in time, he never had a Discord, only for his secret moderator Discord to be leaked in January of 2020. Damn, this dude really does suck when it comes to having things being leaked. So, with all this heat on him, DSP had to address this on stream. And he had the smoking gun to completely null and void all these bullshit accusations. All he had to do was show his phone on stream and show the world that that account was not his. I wonder what he has to say.
All of this shit, and I'm so confused in my head. This guy says Supercard, someone else says it's another game. I don't even know what the fuck you're talking about anymore. Because even you idiots can't get your shit straight, so I don't even know what the fuck you're talking about. I don't care. I'm not going to waste fucking time holding phones up and showing you shit. You're out of your fucking mind. In addition, like I said, chances are, what would happen? I hold it up. Oh, God, there was something on the screen now that's more personal information that got out that they can use against me. Fuck this. And fuck you for even bringing that shit up.
Yeah, that definitely doesn't scream, I have something to hide. But anyways, the Kiwis continued to talk to the members of the Uselessness Faction and kind of ramped things up a bit. This DSP was confronted and asked to prove that it was not DSP, and he refused to, so they booted him. He then created his own faction by the name of the Placeholders.
JoeTaco13 Cheery says, who are the Placeholders? What the hell that means, but thanks for the cheer. The Placeholders, no idea. Who are the Placeholders? You mean in regards to this game? I don't know. Why do I guess it's another fucking meme of some sort that I just don't understand, right?
That is the body language of somebody telling the truth. Now, in May 10th, 2020. He left his own faction to go join the faction called the Road Warriors, despite being known as an account that if you let him into your faction, you're going to get fucked with. Later on in May, he was able to do something that you're not able to do in this game, specifically laid out within the terms of service of it. He was able to change his name.
Enter the Gun Show 84.
Call me Brazy TV $1.37. What's up, Phil? What does the Gun Show mean? I don't know. What are you talking about? What does the Gun Show mean? In reference to me, I have no idea.
I guess if you spent $40,000 on the game, the developers are willing to bend the rules for you just a smidgen to keep that money flowing in. He left the Road Warriors, came back, left, and then came back once again for good with a second name change this time. Now he's going by Down From The Rafters, which is what he's still going by to this day. Now, he was catching a lot of heat on stream for this and finally addressed it once again. Do you think he's going to show the phone?
I'm seriously done with it. Like, there's no point in me talking about it anymore because it's over. They used that to try to make me not get bankruptcy. I got it. So what are you doing? How much more time can you waste of your life on this nonsense you fabricated? It's not working. For me to pick up my phone right now and waste time downloading the game and showing you, oh, here's my login and everything. Number one, that's giving them exactly what they want. That's giving you personal information. I will show, if I even show you a thing on my phone, they'll find something on there to fuck me over.
While the bankruptcy portion of that is semi-true, the main reason people are harping on you about it, DSP, is because for the past, what, 4 fucking years, you have been crying poor on the internet, giving excuse after excuse for your fucking e-begging, and you've been pouring over $40,000 into a fucking Candy Crush ripoff? That's why people are fucking mad. But it's even funnier that DSP said that he doesn't want to reveal the phone because of personal information and bullshit, but has absolutely no problem showing his phone on stream, not even a month and a half later from that fucking rant. Now, after that, things just sort of died out and people kept looking at the account, but there wasn't that much new information. Until the smoking gun. In early December of 2020, it was found out that the Down From The Rafters account joined a faction that didn't use Discord to communicate. Instead, they used the Line app. Line is basically just a WhatsApp. It's a way for people around the world to communicate on their phone in group text messages and all that other bullshit. The kicker, though, is that with Line, you have to put your phone number into it so that way they can verify the account. You cannot make an account without the phone number that you put in to that account because you need the code from the SMS message. Why is this important? Well, DSP was doxxed back in 2014. And if you just so happen to take the phone number from his dox and put it into the Line app, it brings up the Down From The Rafters account. Now, I'm not going to provide the phone number because once again, I do not condone doxing. But if you don't believe me, here's me calling it.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system.
Phil Burnell
is not available.
Like, honestly, how can anyone make the claim that this account does not belong to DSP at this point after all of this evidence? Some of you astute viewers may have realized that the Discord account for DSP from the Anonymous leaks is different than the Discord account for the WWE Champions leaks. And that could pose a huge problem to this video. I may not even should be recording this at this point because of that discrepancy. Let's take a look at the Anonymous Discord account for DSP. Oh, it was made on April 13th of 2020. Why does that date sound so familiar? These were screenshotted and leaked on April 13th, 2020. That's why. So you just so happened to create a Discord account on the same day that the WWE Champions Discord account, proving that the account is yours, is leaked. If that doesn't scream suspiciousness and that I have something to hide, like, what else am I supposed to fucking say? Despite all of that, DSP still claims that this is not him. And he even says he has a smoking gun that proves the account isn't his without having to show his phone. So let's take a look at that.
Every single line of data possible. And I had to explain away everything and tell them exactly what everything was. And at the end of the day, there was none of the bullshit that these idiots say. None of it exists. It's completely fabricated bullshit. None of it's proven. Want to know why? Because I had my bankruptcy granted.
See, for a normal person, that would definitely be something that would debunk it. But not for you. Because during your 341 meeting, you listed microtransactions as a business expense.
Anything relating, you know, to the business per the instruction of my tax attorney. So it could be, the cost of a video game, the cost of a subscription for a video game, a microtransaction within a video game, internet, cost of internet every month. It could be cost of, you know, utilities necessary for the business, you know, cost of cell phone for the business.
Now, I'm pretty sure that during a pandemic, the IRS is going to have people comb through the hundreds of thousands of hours of content you have uploaded to YouTube and Twitch to see if you actually spent the money on WWE Champions. Especially, again, just to reiterate it, during a fucking pandemic. So, you really didn't debunk anything considering all the money in WWE Champions that was spent was through microtransactions, and you listed microtransactions as a business expense. Speaking of the 341 meeting, I mean, I'm not going to use this as evidence. I just find it really funny how tripped up he gets during this and how his voice cracks, and you can tell that he's nervous when he hears the words WWE. I mean, check it out.
Okay, what is WWE Network?
Can you repeat that, please?
What is WWE Network?
WWE Network. That is just an on-demand video service.
All right. What's more likely? What's more likely that all of this is true, or these people are no-life losers like they always have been, and they're just trying to derail me from having fun on stream, right?
Okay, DSP, let's play that game. What's more likely? All of these things need to be true in order for this account not to belong to you. A deep cover troll created a WWE Champions account around the same time that you admitted to playing WWE Champions with the sole intention of impersonating. They then had to have poured thousands and thousands of dollars of their own hard-earned money into the game. Again, to frame you. They then faked these Discord messages and leaked them in order to make it seem like you were talking and again, further frame you. They somehow hacked into your phone and downloaded the Line app, hooked up the Line app to that Down From The Rafters account and left it there on your phone. Or, diligently, every single day, go to their service provider and check to see if your phone number was available just in case you changed it. Again, with the sole intention of framing you, and eventually was able to obtain that phone number and keep the voicemail. Now, all of that needs to be true, or you're playing WWE Champions. What's more likely? In conclusion, folks, DSP is a lying, scamming piece of shit. And if there's any lesson you should take away from this video, it's that you should never give this fucking piece of shit money. But I hope you all enjoyed yourself. If you did, drop me a like, maybe a sub, maybe a share. If you're a DSP fan, for some fucking reason, drop me a dislike and an angry comment. But if you watch this, just make sure you participate, you ugly piece of shit. I'll see you all in episode 2. Until then, I'm Monster. Peace the fuck out.